And heads, I dump it, and loons with air.
Hi, welcome to the new music. I'm Lori Brown. This is Denise Dolan, and she has a dilemma. Denise?
Lori, that Kiss interview is the perfect lead-off for this show, but I don't want to run it.
Why? Why not run a heads? Why not run a Kiss interview?
It's Kiss.
Yeah, but there are millions of Kiss fans out there who are saying, run it, Denise, run it, run it.
Yeah, the problem is I wanted something different in a Kiss interview. I went in there, researched to hear with some serious, hard questions, and all I got was a comedy routine. I came away with the Smothers Brothers.
Well, they're old enough to be the Smothers Brothers.
Run it.
We're here with Kiss, and thank you very much. That was Kiss. That's all that's going to be left of this interview. Okay, we'll use the beginning and the end, eh? Okay.
Well, okay. Maybe just a little bit more. After recording 21 albums, do you go into the studio thinking, yeah, this is something new that I can say this time?
I guess we continue to have things to write about because we continue to live. You know, hopefully every
day. And that's why we have a reason to live.
To live.
Everybody's got a reason.
But truly, I mean, we write songs based on the kind of lives we lead. Miserable.
I don't believe it for a
no.
second.
You know, the biggest problem we ever have is cramps from smiling. I mean,
I don't know. I think you guys must get home from the road and need to be steam cleaned or something. I mean, according to...
Disinfected, at least.
Okay.
Have our minds cleaned, if nothing else.
Realistically speaking, how long can you keep this up?
We're having a good time. I mean, obviously, if this wasn't fun, we'd stop doing it. You know, we have a great time. We write about... We're not writing about nostalgia. We're not writing fantasy. We're writing... our idea of reality. May not be everybody's idea of reality, but that's what makes horse races. There's different things for different people. We don't tell people to live like us, but for anybody who wants to know what it's like without participating, it's fun.
Nevison produced your latest album, Crazy Nights, and the understanding on the street is that you gave Ron Nevison total control as a producer.
When you decide to work with a producer, obviously you want to give as much control to them as possible. You don't do something that goes against what you're all about. We didn't go in and say, mold us. You know, it sounds like a Kiss record. The idea was when there's a difference of opinions, you tend to give them the benefit of the doubt. Otherwise, why would you want to work with somebody? Ron's brilliant because, I mean, he's taken some bands that literally had nothing to offer and has put out some really cool hit records. I'm not talking about Heart. You know, I mean, Heart's great. But
I want Anne.
That's why we worked with Ron.
Everybody keeps
talking
about...
Because Gene wanted Anne's number.
Everybody keeps talking about this little blonde, you know... Pfft. Give me Woman Mountain. Give me the mass of flesh hovering above me, blocking out the sun. Oh, God! She's, music's good, too.
We now return to In Search of Ann Wilson.
Oh,
Richard, you know, I wanted to talk to you about...
No, absolutely not.
Come on, dive in here. About acting, because it seems it's so funny.
Well, then you better talk to an actor.
you know what I love about this interview? This is a classic interview. Not a single question about music.
Okay. Why is it, do you think, that when you talk about metal or hard rock music, people immediately think...
Acting.
No. It's leather, it's studs, it's violence, it's dangerous, it's all those other things.
It's
and
no
music
violence.
Comes really low on the list. Now, is that intentional? Is it a problem?
What
would you rather see it? Music. People don't go, music.
Yeah, but we never claim to be.
Everybody only sees the final result, which is the showmanship and getting up on stage and doing it. Everything starts and ends with a song for us. You know, boy, we're getting serious. All of a sudden, we got very serious. Ooh. Everything starts with an idea, a song. You pick up a musical instrument, and then from there...
You break it.
You know, we get into the embellishment. The truth is, though, that when somebody sees a cake, the thing you see first is the frosting. Ooh, that's deep. And you know, you gotta, if you look at a cake and say, hey, it's all frosting, it's true. Right underneath the frosting, though, we've got cake. We've got stuff, songs. You know, even though KISS scientists have been hard at work for... many, many years trying to put flash pods into our records, all you get are songs. Somebody out there has bought those, who knows, 50, 60, hundreds of billions of records or whatever. It's been 21 albums later, and all that's been on the vinyl are songs.
People like
the music.
I mean, people don't buy
album
in the same quantity. People buy albums depending upon whether they like the songs on them. That's why albums don't always sell the same amount of records. Obviously, when you go on stage, you want to give somebody something more than a live interpretation of a song, because, I mean, that's not what we're all about. You know, we're trying to merge a religious evangelical experience with a let's make a deal or something like that, you know.
When you finally say goodbye to KISS on the road, are you going to do it in some big extravagant explosion like the band did with The Last Waltz and say goodbye forever?
Yeah, we're going to do a disco version of We Are the World.
I see.
Yeah,
uh-huh.
And then that's about all.
That'll sort of stretch you musically, won't you?
That's right.
Yeah.
We're too busy having a good time to even think about it. I mean, you're in the middle of a party and somebody comes over and says, how long are you going to stay at the party? And you just sort of shrug your shoulders and say, I gotta know, I guess as long as it's fun.
Up on the new music, Jethro Tull, Michelle Schacht, and Rye Cooter.
I wanna go home,